We start this morning with some breaking news. More Australian soldiers have been involved in an incident in Afghanistan. The ADF has issued a very brief statement this morning, saying only that their families have been informed. A news conference is about to get underway in Canberra, where the Chief of Defence, General David Hurley, together with the Minister for Defence, Stephen Smith, will give more details. We're just going to cross immediately now to the live news conference, General Hurley in Canberra.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's with great sadness that I'm here this morning to advise you that an Australian soldier was killed in Afghanistan yesterday morning local time, early afternoon Australian time. The soldier was serving with a Special Operations Task Group on an operation in southern Afghanistan when a group of insurgents engaged the partnered Special Operations Task Group and Afghan National Security Forces team with small arms fire. The 35-year-old from the Sydney-based 2nd Commando Regiment sustained a gunshot wound to the head, and despite emergency first aid treatment from a medical officer, he died on the battlefield from his wounds. Overnight, a team from his unit informed the deceased soldier's family of his death. His family has given permission for his name to be released, but I ask that you respect their privacy at this time of grief. Sergeant Todd Langley was an exceptionally experienced and decorated soldier. He was in his fifth deployment to Afghanistan and had also undertaken two deployments to East Timor. Sergeant Langley was awarded two commendations for distinguished service and a unit citation for gallantry. A devoted family man, Sergeant Langley's Special Operations Task Group mates describe him as an exemplary warrior, a true leader, who always brought out the best in those around him. He was a brave and professional soldier who never took a backward step. And despite their grief, his comrades say he will continue to inspire him. On behalf of the ADF and the wider defence organisation, I extend my deepest sympathy to Sergeant Langley's family, his friends and comrades. There are difficult days ahead for them and for us, but we will do everything we can to care and support his family and his mates throughout this time and beyond. In a separate incident during the same operation, a second member of the Special Operations Task Group also sustained a gunshot wound. Combat first aid medics provided immediate first aid, and the wounded soldier was airlifted to the Role 2 medical facility in Tarrant Cot. The wounded soldier has since been transferred to the Role 3 hospital at Kandahar for further treatment, and from there he has contacted his family. He is currently in a serious but stable condition. This particular operation followed on from other recent operations in the same area, which have uncovered large quantities of munitions and IED components. The intent was to disrupt the insurgents' operations and deny them a safe haven to plan, coordinate and execute their operations. As the operation is still ongoing, I will not answer any questions about the immediate events of the day. 28 Australians have been killed in action in Afghanistan, and these men are not numbers. They are fathers, husbands, sons, brothers and mates. They are soldiers, and Australians will not forget their selfless sacrifice. I'll now hand over to the Minister.
Thank you, David. Can I start by expressing my condolences to the family of Sergeant Todd Langley? This will be a tragedy for his family and a tragedy for his mates and his friends. We're going through a very tough period. This will be a particularly tough period for the commandos coming so soon after the tragic death of Sergeant Brett Wood. It's also a tough period for Army and a tough period for the Australian Defence Force generally. It's also a tough period for our nation, where we have to be clear-sighted about our objectives and our role in Afghanistan. At 35, Sergeant Todd Langley was a very experienced soldier, a very experienced commando well respected and well regarded. As the Chief of the Defence Force has said, this is now our 28th fatality in Afghanistan, 7 this year. A heavy blow and a heavy burden for our Defence Force and for our nation. As well, as the Chief has advised, another soldier wounded in the same operation. That brings to over 180 soldiers wounded in the course of our time in Afghanistan, 17 this year. As I've said on numerous occasions in the course of this year, particularly in the run-up to the so-called northern summer fighting season, we could expect two things to occur. We could expect high-profile attacks, which the Taliban and the insurgents would use for propaganda purposes to try and sap political will, not just in Australia, but in the United States and in Europe. And we've seen that on a number of occasions, including very recently. Secondly, that despite the fact that we had taken ground, despite the fact that we had made progress in a security sense, the Taliban would fight back and fight back on the ground, not just in Oruzgan, but in the rest of Afghanistan. And we've seen that occur, and we've seen that occur to terrible consequences. Terrible consequences for the Langley family, terrible consequences for the Australian Defence Force, terrible consequences for our nation. Our role in Afghanistan, of course, is to prevent Afghanistan from again becoming a safe haven for terrorists. We know that we cannot be in Afghanistan forever, and that's why we strongly support the determination of the international community to transition to Afghan-led security responsibility in the course of 2014. And both in Oruzgan and generally, we believe we are on track to effect that. We also strongly believe that in recent times we have made progress. That progress, in a security sense, has been reflected by the very early signs of efforts for political reconciliation or political settlement.